Hi, this is Emily from MinuteEarth. Life and language evolve in many of the same ways. A group splits, and over time, small changes occur in genetic traits in particular words. Over more time, those differences get amplified, eventually leading to new species and new languages. So by looking for similarities between different species and different languages, we can trace their origins and draw their family trees. Except, sometimes, similarities can be misleading. Take the similar-sounding words emoticon and emoji. They describe similar things, so you'd think they'd have similar origins. But emoticon is a combination of the English words emotion and icon, while the word emoji combines the Japanese words for picture and character. So the two words don't actually hint at any hidden relationship between English and Japanese. Other coincidences include the English and Ambaram words for dog, the French and German words for fire, the Malay and Greek words for eye, and the Inuktitut and Turkish words for boat. And similarities in biology can also lead us astray. For example, biologists long thought that these two birds must be sibling species, but recent DNA testing suggests that they're not even on the same evolutionary branch, and may actually be less related than penguins and flamingos. The vultures evolved their bald-headedness independently, probably because they both pursued the same carrion-eating lifestyle. Similarly, these two rodents look so much alike that we named them both porcupine. But in fact, one of them is actually more related to the super soft chinchilla, while the other is more closely related to the very naked, naked mole rat. So it turns out, if you're trying to determine how two things are related, you can't just use one or two data points, even if they're very pointy.